If you look at all these are Ohure. Before the advent of broadcasting and photography, weaving and carving were already in existence in the art of Benin. Uhure, staff of office, is a carved wooden object with a raptor inside the upper arm. This was a sort of representation, like photography, to immortalize the head of the family whenever he passed on to glory. This staff is placed in an altar dedicated to the ancestors, one after another. The said ancestors are canonized, and it is believed that their spirits can answer prayers or convey the prayers to God. It is believed that each ancestor or another during his lifetime had the propensity of a special gift like wealth, wisdom, creativity, good luck, value, love, etc., which he can grant his children and great-grandchildren on request. Their spirits are even ready to answer prayers like the angels and saints do on behalf of the faithful.
So who is this? Who is this person?
Okay, one of the ancestors, one of the elders, one of the Okaibes, drinking, you know, having good time, communicating in the spirit.
Ukures.
Now, ladies and gentlemen, what does the Ukure mean? Ukure is believed to help up the soul and the spirit of the ancestors. In Benin, the Benins were originally not idol worshippers. Whatever idols we find in Benin were actually imported from our Yoruba nation. Yes. For example, Ifa, Oromila is not an indigenous of Benin. Shango is not. Ogun is not.
Was imported.
Imported from the Yoruba nation. However, the Benin man believed in what they call Ehi. They believe also in the ancestors. They believe in the supreme God. In fact, above all, they believe in the supreme God called Usanobu Anowodua.
Yes.
Okute tebite roi, okute tebite negwogo, akpama, okondudu. So they believe in the supreme God. Now, to drive home this point, let me quickly add this one. The Benin, they have been able to give an answer, to provide a real answer to the word ethnography. Ethnography has been described by sociologists as the division of people into lineages, into races, into clans. Clan means large family group. What does that mean? It simply means that the Benins, they are the only race that can boast of over 52 coded salutations when they are shared into different races, into clans. When a child wakes up in Benin, he does not tell the parents, greet the parents, good morning, sir. Good morning, ma. Good morning, sir. No. Such a child is considered as being rude. When you grow up, we were brought up to greet our elders in the coded salutation. A child wakes up to say, Lamogun. It means you belong to the Umogun family. In Edo, we believe that the Umogun family, they are the family of the Obmonoba. That's what it means. We also have Emezi family. And when they wake up, when those children wake up, they say, Lamezio, Emezi Egbenogma Wagyoba. And you know what that means? That also has some traces, in fact, a full dose of royalty. We have Ibiese, Laviese, it's a clan. We have the Laiso, Iso family. We have
Lani.
Name them.
Laviese.
Name them.
Lakun.
Lagesan. Lavatue.
Like how many?
Lamehi.
How many?
Over 52.
52,
right?
Oh, over. Labo. No, over. Over. Labo. There are so many. Labo is there. Latosia is there. Good. Let's begin to name all of them.
Do you think Benin people are preserving these greatness?
Oh, certainly, yes.
They continue.
You have to. For example, you cannot come. I cannot. There's no way I can come to somebody like Prof, who is my father. Huh? Then I belong to the same family with him, and I'll come and say, good morning, sir. He won't answer me.